Match fishing's all about making the decisions. Today I've drawn a mediocre peg and I'll be able to talk you through the decisions that I'm going to make to build a weight during the match. Here I am at Monk Lakes on the second day of a silverfish two-day match. Yesterday I had a real good day, drew peg 38 here on Bridges Lake. It's a real big lake, 16 acres. Big head of carp, obviously, that don't count. But as with a lot of good commercial fisheries now, there's a massive head of silverfish, the bream. There's a few little roach and tench, but it's really the bream you're looking for to build a weight. Yesterday I won the match with 55 pounds. Today I've drawn a mediocre peg. There was 31 pound off here yesterday. He had 7 tench and a few skimmers. There's some a point to my right, which is predominantly the best area of the lake. They caught some 50 pounds there yesterday, so I'm really up against it. And the lad that was third yesterday with 50 pound has drawn the next peg about 3 metres away from where he was yesterday. So, you know, I'm not unhappy with my draw, but obviously he's going to be very hard to beat. Mark Goddard was second. He's drawn an end peg on the far bank, which on paper isn't that good, but he's a fantastic angler, and also being on an end, obviously he's going to catch a few fish. The peg that I've drawn today, peg 8 on Bridges, I am happy with. I've got a little bit of room, hopefully going to catch some bream. There's been a bit of bait going yesterday, which is always a good thing on these big lakes, especially where bream and skimmers are concerned. I'm going to fish 2 long lines on the pole with pellets, a shorter line with maggots, and I've obviously got a feeder set up as well, just to pass the first half hour, 40 minutes, because I don't want to go in on the pole too early. I'm going to feed the pole, long pole line with some micros and some ground bait. Look to fish quite light, 010, double maggot, 2 or 3 dead pinkies, or an expander on the hook. Yesterday I was pegged 38, which is right down the bottom of the lake, 55 pound. I only had 1 tench, but I had quite a few decent bream, a couple of big perch. So it really did go to plan. The overall 2 day is decided on weight, so I really do need to try and catch 40 pound plus today, I would have thought. But I'm not unhappy. There's definitely worse pegs, there's definitely better, but I'm not unhappy at all today. There is a massive head of bream in here. There's been weights in excess of 100 pound. We had quite a heavy frost here last night, so I don't expect the fishing to be amazing. But then again, I think there's going to be some 50 pound plus weights again on these points that do tend to dominate the matches. But I said last night when I was talking that if I can't be on one of the points, I just want a little bit of room. I've got plenty of room here. There's no one to my right to the point, which can be very, very good pegs, like I say. I've got a spare peg to my left and then the lad a couple of pegs up. So we've got a nice lot of room here today. And with bait going in yesterday, you never, ever know. As far as the pole rigs for today's session, I've got 2 4B16 rigs, 016 mainline, 010 hook length and a 16 pellet hook. Quite lucky here today. There's only from my left line to my right line, there's about an inch difference. I have put up 2 rigs because I do like to fish the dead depth. I don't want to fish too far on or too far off on either line. So instead of being lazy like some people, I've put a designated rig up for the left line and one for the right. The left-hand one also doubles up from an 11 metre line where I'm going to feed a few maggots and hopefully catch some tench. So the pole fishing is quite simple. But what you'll notice today is I'm going to feed and try and be quite patient and let the fish come, because if they do turn up the bream, you can rattle out a big weight in quite a short time. Yesterday here he didn't catch too many skimmers, but he did have 7 decent tench. So that is an option, and it is a line that I am definitely going to cover. As far as the feed is concerned, I've set up a normal free running feeder, cage feeder, foot hook length, 012 hook length and a 16 hook, 2 or 3 red maggots, and try and catch an early bream or maybe even a tench in the first half hour while I'm letting everything settle. A lot of people go straight in on the pole, and personally I think that's a mistake, especially with bream like we've done in the past. I'd like to just give it a little bit of time, let them settle, and hopefully then go in and catch a few. It really is a fantastic venue. The sun's out even though it's been a nice cold day. The bait I've got for today's session, I've got a couple of pints of maggots, reds and white mixed. I've got a few dead maggots, some pinkies, some expanders, some micro pellets that I've soaked, and the Old Faithful, the Old Ghost Green Alga, which again, for the bream, is my number one ground bait. A couple of balls in on each line, and then I'll be able to talk you through the decisions that I'm going to make during the match. I'm going to fish two long lines on the pole. I'm going to feed the pole, long pole line with some micros and some ground bait. Feed a couple of decent balls on each line at the start and try and let the bream come to me. I really do need to try and catch 40 pound plus today. And what you'll probably notice is that I'm going to be quite patient and try and let it happen. I fed a line at 11 metres with a few maggots and a few micro pellets, just in case there's any tench in the area. Well, here we are, I've fed the two pole lines, put two balls of ground bait on each line, quite positive. A little bit of a twist because yesterday there was no fish really caught on a normal feeder, only some small fish. And because of the amount of carp anglers that fish here, I decided to change at the last minute, follow my gut instinct and fish a method feeder at long distance towards an island where I know that the carp anglers will spod and feed for the bream. Bearing in mind I'm only looking to catch one or two fish maybe in the first 40 minutes while my pole lines settle. Just felt it was a little bit of a better option because obviously I've got an island to cast to. It's quite a way. But I hooked a few carp yesterday in amongst the big bream. Just get the feeling that they live together. They all move around together. And with the normal feeder not being that productive, just thought I'd take a little bit of a chance and hopefully get one or two pulls on this in the first 40 minutes and just put something in the net. Obviously you got a chance of hooking an odd carp as well, but hey ho, you know, yesterday I caught some bream, 3, 3.5, 4 pound in amongst the carp. And like on a lot of commercial fisheries, the bigger bream tend to move around with the carp. I fed a line at 11 metres with a few maggots and a few micro pellets, just in case there's any tench in the area. There's also odd weird fish like big barbel, perch, fish like that. And when you're never really sure how it's going to fish, it's about covering your options. Could easily come here and just fish it for bream, thinking it's going to be really good. And you could easily get caught out if 30, 35 pound wins the match. So it's about covering all the options. But like I say, I've started on a method feeder. Three dead red maggots, a little bit of green algae and some micro pellets. Wow, look, something on the way in there. Little fish. Tench. Thanks for coming to the party. Getting a few bites on this method. I've had a tench, about £3, and two skimmers, and I've got another skimmer on now. Might be a case of fishing this for a couple of hours, you know. Send a few over here, Lenny. A little burst of two or three and then gone. Just give it 10 minutes on that pole. Things on that pole, you know pretty soon if they're there or not. You get a little indication, you know. Keep putting an odd fish in the net though, you know, or try to. Might be a case of doing this for 3 hours, you know, just getting an odd, try and catch double figures and hopefully catch 20-30 pound late on the pole. Long way to bring them. Here we are about an hour and 25 minutes into the match, and the fishing's very difficult. Like I explained earlier on the point pegs, not only are they out in the lake, but they're a bit deeper and they are catching quite a few fish. I've had one little tiny skimmer on the pole here, which isn't really what I wanted. I wanted to go in on that pole after 40 minutes and start catching some skimmers and maybe even some bream, but I just don't think they're here. Lad next to me's had one fish on the pole. I've had one fish, and yet on the point pegs they've probably got in excess of 20 pound already. So it's not looking good at the moment, but match fishing's all about making the decisions and trying to just winkle out what you can. I've probably got about 7 pound at the moment, 4 or 5 skimmers and that tench. And all I'm doing is just keeping the pole lines fed. I've topped them both up. I'm going to be aggressive on the pole because obviously need to catch.
Obviously need to catch a weight of fish to win it over the 2 days. So I'm just being positive on that pole.
Putting in another big ball on each line.
Because they're obviously just not there. When your float started right down, you can tell if those bream are in your peg. Yesterday I knew instantly, and they're just not here. So what I'm doing is just neglecting the pole line a little bit, just leaving it and hoping that they'll turn up. Meanwhile, trying just to put whatever I can in the net.
Like I say, we've got another skimmer on here. Even if I can just catch 10, 12 pound and then they turn up on the pole, you've always got to be try and be optimistic.
And I'm just trying to tread water, put an odd fish in the net until they turn up on the pole. They might not turn up on the pole, but like I say, you've got to be hopeful. They're hooking lots of fish on this point, and they were both well up there yesterday. They've actually drawn the same two pegs, Paul Lamb and Lenny Goodwin. Both very good anglers, and when you get good pegs over the 2 days, they're going to be very, very hard to beat. But the good thing is on these lakes is that you never know. All of a sudden you can have a peg full of bream on the pole, and that's what can happen. And that's what I'm obviously hoping will happen.
Just taking my time with each and every one. Not catching a big enough weight, but you never know, if I have a good last 2 hours on the pole, these fish that I'm catching now could be absolutely vital. Not sure what this is. I thought it was a skimmer. I hope it's not a little carp.
Again, like I say, these fish at the end
could be absolutely vital.
Okay, nice tench, probably a pound and a half. But like I say, we really do need to catch some fish on the pole.
trying to catch something anywhere, really, you know, but at the same time trying to be a little bit positive, because obviously need to catch a weight of fish to win, you know. Might be a tench. I'm on the pole now. I've just caught a few smaller skimmers, but no big ones. Just really just hoping that it's gonna happen. I'm on the pole, catch some bigger fish. I have had a tench on the pole. No decent bream yet. The ones I need to catch a big enough weight. I think I'm just gonna really stick with the pole. Still getting a very odd bite on the method, but I'm not gonna catch a big enough weight, so I really need to just stick with the pole, alternating the two lines. I've tried where I fed for tench and not had a bite. So I've really just knocked that on the head now. I'm going to concentrate on these two long lines. Stick to my guns and just hope that a few fish do turn up. Obviously a few people are catching around the lake. Mark Goddard on the end peg opposite's catching a few. And the point pegs are still catching a few. But right about now it's just about concentrating and just trying to put whatever I can in the net.
Thank you.
are with about an hour and a half to go. I've had an odd fish on the pole, but it's never really started to happen. Got four or five tench now, one decent bream and a few smaller skimmers. Bites are definitely slowing up, but Mark's still catching quite well on the other bank. So it's all still to play for. We've got an hour and a half to go, and these bigger fish, they can turn up. The main priority is to put whatever I can in the net, no matter how big they are. Could make a big difference at the end. So I've fed my tench line a couple more times, but I've had no indications at all there. The tench I have caught on the pole have been on the longer line. Just trying to make every bite count, because, you know, one or two more decent fish and another dozen smaller skimmers and could make a big difference at the end, you know. But the right hand line definitely isn't as productive, but I've caught a tench and an odd fish. It's just somewhere to go to rest my left hand line, really. Even then, because I don't think anyone's really running away with it. I think the two lads on the point and Mark have probably got more than me. But two or three decent fish in that last hour, and you don't know. It's obviously an odd better one about, because I've had that one decent one. I just thought I'd have 10 minutes back on a method, just leave me pole. I just can't get a bite anywhere now. Yeah, I don't want to just keep piling baiting. I'm just going to leave mine. Because yesterday, I kept putting it in. And it just went in the end. Gone. Got one on method me. Just shows that tiny amount of bait out there and it's kept fish in the area, you know. Keep piling it in on the pole and it don't happen. there we go, the fish are all weighed in. There's still a few people on the other bank. I managed to beat Paul and Lenny on the point. It just goes to show that just winkling those odd fish out when times are hard, just swapping to the feeder, resting your lines, and just keep putting odd fish in the net, even when you think your back's against the wall and you're behind, because at the end, those few fish can pay off. Paul's had 40 pound, Lenny's had a high 30, and I've managed to catch 43. So I'm over the moon with here. I think Ian, Germaine and Mark are probably both gonna beat me. It's very difficult to say. Ian Germaine's caught a lot of fish and they look like decent sized tench. He had 38 pound yesterday and could well win it over the 2 days. I'm hoping that he hasn't got anywhere near as much as I think, and then that'll give me a chance. But I've beat Lenny and Paul, so it's really down to Mark and Ian Germaine just to see what they've caught. The two lines have worked well. The tench line didn't produce anything, no bites, but again, I had it fed, and another day you could go on it and catch two or three fish, and those fish could make the difference. If I had to sum it up, I'd say switching, starting on the method, and then going back on the method when I caught a decent bream of about 2.5 pound and another one about 1.5 pound the next chuck. Just those two fish alone, switching back, have helped me to beat Paul by about 3 pound. So that just shows the importance of not just sitting there. A lot of the time at this style of fishing, a rest is definitely the best way. If the fish have gone, instead of just piling the feeding, just leave it, almost as if you're just neglecting it, and then go back on it 20 minutes, half hour later. And quite often, like I've done today, you can keep a few fish coming. As far as a tactical decision, I changed with 10 minutes before the match started from a normal feeder to a method. I know these bream hang around with the carp. These are good carp pegs and they fish to the island. They spot a lot of bait. So I decided at the last minute to change to a method. And I really do think it was the right decision, as I've caught 2 tench and 7 or 8 decent sized skimmers for about 12, 13 pound on the method feeder. I'm really pleased with that. I'm hoping that that could make a difference, but I do think Ian and Mark could well push me. I'm gonna have a drive around the other side now and see what they weigh in.
Results, lads. I know it's been tough for some of you, but good for others. That's the way of two.
Right, here comes the nitty gritty overalls. In fourth place with 89 pounds, 12 ounces, Paul Lamb.
Thank you.
In third place overall, Dean Lock with 91 pounds, 12 ounces. Second place overall, Ian Germaine with 95 pounds.
Thanks for coming to the party.